It's 9 p.m. Saturday evening. We are back from primary customer research. This process takes a lot of energy, but gives a lot of wisdom. So let's remind ourselves, why do we do it? We do primary customer research because we are looking for a homogeneous group of target customers who experience a similar problem and to whom you could deliver your solution at similar cost and who would pay similar amounts of money for that solution. So let's review where we are. In the online retail industry, we are looking at the apparel market because we are looking to sell clothing. The apparel market could be subdivided into multiple market segments, the notable ones of which are casual clothing, professional clothing, and sports clothing. Now, what's important to recognize is that each of those market segments could be divided into more specific subsegments that are based on style, such as urban, modern, preppy, classic. And even more specific subsegments based on the price factor of the clothing, from inexpensive to very expensive. Now, as you can see, we're getting progressively more specific on our path to find our persona around whom we'll build our business. We're in a good place, but don't relax just yet. Our goal now is to find several market segments that are interesting and promising and do more research and analysis. In the process, ask the following questions. Who is the end user? In one of our segments, for example, the end user could be a male in his early 30s who doesn't care very much about fashion but wants to dress well and has a classic style. He has a decent job, works very hard, so he doesn't have a lot of time for shopping, which is why online is important to him. He makes a good amount of money but not enough not to care about getting discounts to buy good clothing. Let's call him Josh. What is the application? Why would the end user use your service? In our case, Josh would use us to buy products far in advance at a discount. But not just that, also ask what tasks would be dramatically improved by the end user using your product. What is the benefit? What problem is solved by your end user using your product? Does the end user save time? Does the end user save money? Does the end user make more money? You have to ask those questions. Who are the lead customers? That is, the influential customers, through whose example others would be compelled to use the service. What are the market characteristics that would promote or impede the adoption of your product? Clothing, for example, is a market that is driven by fashion, which changes fast. How will this affect how Josh or other end users view our service? What is the market size of the segment that you're looking to target? We're going to cover the estimation of your market size later in this course. What is the competition? If Josh cares about good classic clothing at a discount, can he solve that problem with different providers? Who are the necessary partners? For us to be able to sell clothing to Josh, we need to work with clothing manufacturers and clothing retailers. What are the complementary assets required? For Josh to shop with us, he needs to have either a computer or a mobile phone with an internet connection, and definitely a credit card. Sounds obvious, and it is, with technologies as ubiquitous as a mobile phone or a computer. But it's often not that obvious with more complex products. Let's see where we are. We started at the top, our industry, online retail. And we progressed methodically in specificity. And now we have a hypothetical end user, Josh. Now, we may be completely wrong in our assumption that Josh would be interested, But that doesn't matter. At least we can go and find people like Josh and learn more about them, interview them directly. We'll get a definitive answer without beating around the bush and wasting time and resources. We'll move on to a different segment, a different set of end users, and we'll continue on our journey to find the persona that will be at the foundation of a good and sustainable business for us. Good luck.